My name is Tomasz Zachorski. I'm proxy of the management board at Legia Warsaw Football Club. I'm responsible mainly for supervising sports infrastructure, sports administration and sports legal operation, as well our research and development unit. I'm also CEO of a special purpose vehicle company, which is responsible for construction and operation of our future training facilities and Legia Lab. It is necessary for Legia to build a new training center because so far we have limited options in terms of infrastructure. We only have two additional training pitches by our stadium. The stadium itself is a state-of-the-art state-of-the-art venue, as you can see. But in terms of training infrastructure, we had a gap, and we were certainly looking forward to invest in this field. That's why, in terms of our future development and expanding our youth academy and making it one of the leading ones in Europe, we found it's a crucial investment for us. So we plan to build altogether 9,000 square meters of a building, of an office space, of dressing rooms, offices for the coaches, but also 24 rooms for the first team players of a four-star hotel standard, but also 30 rooms for the youth academy dormitory. So this is the in terms of the main building, plus up to 8 football pitches and some additional sporting infrastructure. We are starting our construction most probably in August. We are now in the middle of a tender process to choose a general construction company. And we plan to start the construction in August 2018, and then aim to complete the construction within 13 months, around September 2019, and then starting from October, relocate relevant parts of our club from the stadium to the training facilities. Legia Lab is still in the early stages of the project. We have recruited a lot of people already in our staff in terms of medical rehabilitation, nutrition, mental preparation and other areas. So they work on the regular basis with the first team, with the second team. And now we also want to, and we're already building the structure of the Legia Lab as a typical R&D unit. We already received some subsidies for these purposes, and we're planning to build on their knowledge and know-how to generate specific ideas to help us both internally to grow as the club, but also to commercialize certain ideas and concept for our fan base and for a wider community. Yeah, we're planning that part of the facilities will be open to the public. We want to be to integrate ourselves with the local community. And this new training facilities will be located around 25-30 minutes from our stadium on the outskirts of Warsaw. So we always cooperate very closely with the local communities, and this will be also the case. So partly the training facilities will be open to the public. We also have signed cooperation agreements with Polish Football Association and with the Mazovian Football Association, which is like a kind of a regional football association. So we count, and we are sure that some of the, especially youth teams of the Polish Federation and Mazovian Federation will also use the facilities. For now, we are still considering these options, and certainly we encourage our partners and sponsors to contribute, and we'll give them relevant possibility. But this is still in process, in talks, so there's nothing specific for now to communicate. Yeah, members of the project team have visited, has visited altogether around 30 training facilities all over Europe. Obviously, we travel a lot with our team on the, during the European games, so we used each and every occasion while playing with teams like Real Madrid, Sporting Lisbon, Borussia Dortmund, Ajax Amsterdam, and many others to visit their facilities, which are obviously leading in Europe. But we also visited a number of other ones all over Europe, the ones which already exist, but also the ones which are now in similar phase like ours in terms of planning. So we exchange a lot of thoughts and ideas with a lot of experts around Europe, and it was very helpful, I think, for us, but also for other clubs. And we have many, we take in many concepts from different clubs, but at the end of the day, it's our project of our architects, of our team. But we were very thankful to the European clubs, the community, for the openness. We also, we always act the same, so we are always open to host other clubs and people, and this is part of our identity and how we operate. Many of them. So I would say if I'll, you know, we'll have to name them, it'll be a very long conversation, so I won't name them, but we've taken many concepts from many clubs, something from Real, something from Ajax, something from RB Leipzig, and so on, so on. So it was really very useful, very, very inspiring. And I think it will be the same with our training facilities. As soon as people will come to our place, they will also be inspired, and it will be a learning curve. No, the training center in principle will be for the first and second team, and also the senior teams from the academy, starting from under 15-16, but obviously the training facilities itself and the building will be divided into relevant parts with restricted access, so that academy players can see their idols and their colleagues from the senior team, but still there will be like a healthy division between them. And they know that they have to achieve a lot, work hard to someday make a debut in the first team of Legia Warsaw. So now it's May 2018. We are in the middle of the tender process. We want to finalize it with signing of the agreement with the construction company in July. And then in August we should start the construction phase, which will last for about 12-13 months. September 2019 we should have the permit to use the building, and then October 2019 start of the relocation. Of course, as you know very well, and many clubs and all other entities have also experienced it in infrastructure projects, the delays are part of the game, but we are planning, I would say, responsibly, and we trust that this plan and schedule is one we can deliver. But you never know. But we will do our best, and we have a very good team of people, advisors on board, and experts. So we trust this is the final schedule. We did, and it was very useful. I mean, ESMA always organizes their events very well and in a thoughtful way. So we've been for a couple of days, visited a number of facilities. Always the most important value is to be able, within a short period of time, to meet a lot of experts in one place in a coordinated way. Very well, everything is very well organized, scheduled. So this is the key advantage of similar opportunities. Many takeaways from such visits and workshops. We always then sum them up in a presentation, internal presentation, show to our project team, share and store it in our knowledge management system. So it's always a very valuable thing to experience.